Hi, this is Dr. Westman with another Learn with Dr. Westman episode. Today I'm going to talk about keto not working, drop the nuts. So why drop the nuts? Well, there's something about nuts that make you want to eat more nuts. Have you noticed this to be true? Careful, most people who do consume nuts put them into little baggies or little containers or get them in self-contained packages so that they don't have access to the full tub of nuts that are already cracked and opened for you. Best advice I can tell you if you want to start a low-carb keto diet to lose weight or to reverse diabetes is to not have nuts. So if you're at a plateau, you want to get to work again, don't have nuts. And by nuts, I mean, yes, almonds are nuts, cashews are nuts, and I do mean peanuts too, even though technically they're legumes, but most people think of them as nuts, and it's a very common a problem to not be able to stop eating peanuts. Has that happened to you? And then, of course, macadamia nuts count in there. But not just nuts, it's also nut butters. So have you had, you know, peanut butter? Have you ever noticed that you eat half the jar or the whole jar of the peanut butter or the almond butter or cashew butter or macadamia nut butter? Now, down the road, when you're at your goal, macadamia nut butter, cashew butter, almond butter are fabulous things to have and to incorporate back into your lifestyle, but not when you're trying to lose weight or reverse diabetes. So I mean nuts, nut butters, and also no nut flours. So that means no almond flour, no coconut flour. So you're gonna learn from people on the internet who are using these, they're teaching you, and many of them have not had to lose weight on their own. Many of them are trying to be healthy for other reasons, or they're already at their ideal weight or metabolic state. So, but if you're trying to lose weight or reverse diabetes or other metabolic problem, you don't want to have almond flour or coconut flour. You don't want to be recreating these keto / cookies with flours. And trust me, I mean, this is a advice from clinical practice that I've had for 20 years, but also I learned from doctors who were using this in their clinical practice for 30 years before that. So my story is right around the year 2000, I went to visit doctors who were using a keto diet, Dr. Atkins, Dr. Bernstein, Dr. Eads, Dr. Rosedale, and I asked, what do you do? So I learned from their clinical practices, and what we did is we formalized that clinical practice into research. So our studies have been published in major peer-reviewed journals ever since the year 2000. So what was happening more recently is that people came to me, what they were being taught wasn't working, and when I teach what we've used for a long time, things just start to work. And one of the major things that I find people have success with is dropping the nuts. And that means nuts, nut flours, nut butters. Now, a lot of people will ask me why. And in fact, there's a growing number of people who won't just trust me, you know, trust me, I'm a doctor, and which I don't just trust me, you know, it has to work for you. In fact, if it doesn't work and for 2 weeks, try something else. This should be working, you know, almost immediately for you when it's done right. But, you know, I can't really explain why the nuts make it so it doesn't work. But there are three or four possibilities. One is that you overconsume carbs. So 1 ounce of nuts has about six total grams of carbs, and we always use total grams, not net grams, because some people do absorb the fiber, and sugar alcohols can affect the keto metabolism. So you want to use total carbs. But if you have 1 ounce of any kind of nuts, you're at 6 total carbs, and at first we want people to stay under 20 for the day for this to work for, you know, everyone the first time, every time, prescription strength keto. 6 grams is a lot. And 6 grams is actually, if it's multiplied by 2 or 3, gets you very quickly up to that 20 gram limit. Remember, you have to burn through all of the carb grams before you start burning your body fat. That's why we limit the carbs, and that's why a low carb diet is really a keto diet, a ketogenic diet, because the ketones come from your own body fat. So if you get a tub of nuts because they're cheaper, and you end up having one handful, that's 6 grams, and then the day goes by, you're working at home, you're hungry, you go and you get another handful, well, that's another 6 grams, and you get the point. So, you know, if you are one of the rare few who are able to only have just a few nuts, and some people can, it's not fair, then, you know, go ahead and have the nuts. But if you're someone who is unable to control them, then just be honest, drop them, and take the two-week test of it to see if that doesn't turn the corner for you. So it might be that there are too many carbs. It might be that there are too many calories, because nuts are very high in calories. And if you're kind of at the edge of wanting the low-carb keto diet to work for weight loss, but you're not very active, you're unable to be active. A lot of people come to me in chronic pain and they can't exercise. So if you're trying to have the diet do all of the work for you, then you want to be careful about high calorie items as well. So nuts have a lot of calories, so that may be another reason why dropping the nuts is so effective. The third reason is it's a trigger food for most people. Now, I've been in front of audiences of people following keto diets. I've had the probably thousands of people now, if you added them all up, and I'll take a straw poll survey of people there. You know, how many of you have trouble with nuts? And, you know, it's at least 50%. So remember, if I'm going to be teaching you something that's going to work the first time, every time, and 50% of the time letting you have nuts will make it not work, that's high enough that I'm not going to let you have nuts, because I don't know if you're going to be one of the, you know, it's like flipping a coin. It's very likely you might have trouble with nuts. A trigger food is something that you eat that makes you want to eat more. And nuts are the classic trigger food. Has this not happened to you? You know, be honest. But the final thing, so carbs, calories, trigger foods. A trigger food is something you eat to the bag or package size. It's generally not the fullness that makes you stop. So even something like pork rinds can be a trigger food. If you find yourself eating to the whole bag until the bag is done, you're not stopping because of your fullness. You're stopping because the packaging is there. So that's really what a trigger food is, something you can't stop. But then there's a fourth thing, and that is people tell me that when they eat nuts, the other foods just aren't quite as satisfying. So there's a remaining kind of residual desire to have more, that people don't feel quite so full. And I don't know why. The mechanistic research is way behind the clinical observation in the keto low-carb world. So hopefully one day we'll figure out what that mechanism is for a trigger food or nuts, for example, that just make you not be satisfied with the other foods like you used to be satisfied. So let me know down below if I'm speaking to you, that drop the nuts for a couple weeks and see if you're not satisfied where before you weren't satisfied. Now you will be satisfied. So there's something about those nuts, especially, well, for me personally, it's cashews. You know, and I can eat a small number, but then the rest of the day, I'm just not. So I could be within the carb limit and the calorie limit, but then the rest of the day, I'm just not quite fully satisfied and still want something more. So let me know if this resonates with you. And so if you want a prescription strength keto diet to work the first time, every time, for something like obesity, weight loss, or reversal of diabetes or other metabolic syndrome, give yourself the best chance and just drop the nuts. And by nuts, I mean nut butter and nut flours. Don't have those either. Be sure to click down below for some tips on how to start keto the right way. And I hope that's helpful.